The United States is the only country in the world that began with the latest technology.
A great nostalgia for television.
This is the cliche archetype theme. Notice how TV went around the movies and scrapped them, and then retrieved the silence, and retrieved the old movies as art forms.
Mm-hmm.
That's the cliche archetype theme. That new cliche or surround will retrieve old cliche.
Gutenberg.com.
I don't need the Pope to tell me how the world functions. I can find that out for myself. Because to me, the world is just a machine. He made the clock into a central metaphor. He said, I consider the human body as nothing but a machine. A healthy man is like a lovemade cook. A sick man is a lovemade cook.
Well, the metaphor seems a little clumsy now, but it worked, didn't it?
Yes, so successfully that...
It is therefore having the hardest time of any country in the world in orienting itself in the electric.
TV, unlike the fantasy world, the escape world of the movies, TV creates enormously serious and realistic-minded sort of person, well, almost oriental in his meditativeness. I think
this is the teenager of today.
Yes, he's becoming almost oriental in his inwardness.
It's trash, just as they do most TV shows.
Uh-huh.
Now, what will surround TV to turn TV into an art form? Something is waiting in the wings. Maybe it's holographic.
It's a portable holographic camera. It'll project your image up to a half mile away, 100% audio send and receive capabilities.
It's a prototype. Confuse and deceive the enemy.
Now, it has a mini-nuke battery, good for about 8 minutes, but you can only use it once.
So you better save it for when it counts.
Hardest time of any country in the world in orienting itself in the electric age.
He's so thoughtful and serious.
Yeah, grim. The movie generation.
I'll tell you what's alive and what you're not paying any attention to, and that's the satellite environment. The classroom is not having any influence on you. The satellite environment is having a profound influence on you and your being here this afternoon.
Sure, great.
But you know why?
Could it be the long-awaited William Murderface side project Planet Piss?
But the satellites as a new garbage or climate surround around the planet.
A strip teacher puts on her audience by taking off her clothes.
I put you on
by baring my mind. I put you on as an audience. I wear you as my clothing.
Do you think that this is an equal discussion?
It isn't.
That you are equal to each one of us, or do you think you are equal to the whole group? Because it's mostly.
Well, ask a strip teaser.
Is
a strip teaser equal to the whole group?
I don't usually think of a discussion group like that.
Now, the stripteaser has to bear herself in order to put on her audience. And when she puts on her audience, she is a corporate power. When she steps off the stage, she is a private nobody.
But you can see from the miniskirt, which is that the end is in sight. The miniskirt is a costume worn by all tribal people, men and women alike. The miniskirt means the end of sex. Unisex has come. Until 1710, the word sex was never used once to mean allure. It was used to mean gender. We're back at that stage. Sex as allure has ended. Sex is now a technical term meaning male or female.
Do you miss doing it with me? I miss you too. You're so cute. I don't have time for a boyfriend or anything.
Thanks to overdoing it, I wrote this in Playboy some months ago.
Well, we should do something.
The reversal of the overheated medium. When we step up sex a bit, it ceases to be sex. It just becomes what it is for all tribal people, a mild. And
tomorrow.
Very, well, like coffee to us. Very casual. Sex as an exciting, enthralling, alluring thing is finished.
And the miniskirt is shouting that out very loud.
We're just having a good time.
Well, then don't keep them all to yourself. It's antisocial.
Are moving information at speeds that the planet cannot cope with.
This is going to happen.
This is really going to happen. The key word here is organization. It's all about being professional.
We're not even on the planet. We're not even in the galaxy. We're somewhere else. So therefore, there's no nations, and there's no worlds, there's no corporations, and there's very little nature. As categories. When Ben Franklin started the United States, it was based on the newspaper and the Bible and books.
Yeah.
That was a real environment.
The United States.
It was a hidden environment that was having effects on people, inspiring people with new notions and getting away from the European medieval constructs based on the manuscript culture.
It's the only country in the world that began with the latest technology.
But then the United States had to confront the telegraph environment less than 100 years later. That created the American Civil War, because whenever you bring in a new technological communication environment, it will cause an identity crisis of the identity based on previous media of communication.
Yes.
So the electric simultaneity of the telegraph shocked the dimensions that had been established by the printing press.
Gutenberg technology. Gutenberg technology.
Right.
From the 3rd century A.D. till the Renaissance, the reason the book survived was scripture. With Gutenberg, the press reached out and grabbed antiquity for the first time. The Middle Ages had no way of printing ancient books.
Felt everywhere at once, under a single date line.
But that's not the same thing as controlling nature, dominating
nature.
Superseding nature. It's far from that.
Oh.
I mean, nature still does exist as a protagonist on this planet.
Oh, yeah. But it's like our Victorian mechanical environment. It's a rearview mirror image. Every age creates as a utopian image, a nostalgic rearview mirror image of itself, which puts it thoroughly out of touch with the present. The present is the enemy. The present is the, and this will delight you, Norman, the present is only faced in any generation by the artist.
And then everybody, the whole world, we don't know how many people watched it on the internet or watched it on TV, but I tell you, billions of people watched it. And they watched it burn. And we don't know the effects of human consciousness bringing in the Sheldrake's morphogenetic effect, or as other people call it, the Isaiah factor. You bring in the mind melt of everybody watching that. And a large part of the audience ain't Americans, and they think it's great, at least subconsciously. We had willed these towers to be busted because we were sick of the New World Order through the 90s. A lot of the world didn't like the effects of globalization. So you have that rage, and you have that wonder, and you have that fascination, you have that love and worship of the towers, all concentrating for, 45 minutes? The humiliation factor for those towers was so intense that the buildings committed suicide. Now, some would say, well, that violates any kind of idea. That's total fantasy, Bob. No, it isn't. If you realize that we don't understand that when minds are looking at one dramatic image for a long time simultaneous, we don't know what that effect is. I know when there were fires in Malibu in 93 in L.A., a friend of mine would watch it, and the fires would die down, and the journalists would come on and say, hey, the fires are dying down, and then within 10 minutes the fires would go back up because everybody was watching it. We think there's a division between us and matter. There isn't. And so the reason the building collapsed was not because of new hardware, it was because of the software effect of global consciousness looking at something and watching the drama, and the buildings themselves were so humiliated they committed suicide.
Come on. The
moon. Now, I know that's hard to believe, but I'm on the right track because it's incredible. And the big discoveries are always protected by public incredulity of the fuel burning. But the thing is, now I'm laying out this incredible scenario. Guess who came up with this?
Who?
The great student Mark McLuhan, Jean Baudrillard.
Oh, well, that makes perfect sense that he would come to that.
That's right, because he wrote a famous essay.
Rob, you're an artist. Yeah. Who would have thought to use a psychedelic projector to paint pictures on the sky and panic the city out of their paychecks? Boy.
Gutenberg reached out and grabbed Greece and Rome and dumped it into the Renaissance lap as a huge pile of garbage. And it kept creative minds very busy dealing with garbage for a long time. Artists love garbage and slums. So the future of creativity is colossal in the world of garbage. We have creativity will be king from now on as we create successively new and massive planetary scopes of garbage. I haven't even asked myself very much about the effects of laser on printing.
So that we now are superior to any major former media environments. But we need to recycle their memes to create economic exchange, what Jean Baudrillard calls the ecstasy of communication.
You know what my fear is?
Oh my, yes. But not this year, because my latest invention is unbeatable. Behold, the death clock.
I just hope this doesn't get bigger than death clock. You know, that'd be something, you know.
Well, I will tell you this, that's a good problem to have.
Huh, I guess.
That's a problem you want to have. That's a good one.
Hey, look at that. That's a problem you want to have.
Let's go in there. Let's do it.
Hold on. Just gather myself. Get ready.
Well, we've been here sitting for 5 hours.
Well, it just doesn't happen overnight.
Talking.
Sunday.
Okay.
Sunday.
How you doing?
The genius will invent new technologies, right?
Right.
So the subgenius is looking at the effects of the genius.
Now, my writing has for years been concerned with the effects of things, not their impact, but their consequences after impact.
Any Armageddon has already happened to our psyche.
The effects of things, not their impact, but their consequences after impact.
All these things are just potentialities, and you can begin to look at it like postmodern mathematics or postmodern quantum physics.
Now, within the shells, the electrons are everywhere at the same time, so to speak. But the probability patterns that resemble shells are extremely stable and very hard to compress.
Matter is solid because probability patterns are difficult to compress.
That's as good as it gets.
If the doors of perception were cleansed, everything would appear as it is, infinite.
William Blake.
Visual space is the alphabet. It's abstract, it's black and white. All right, if you're misunderstanding, visual space disappeared a long time ago when the photograph came in, and then the movie and, of course, television. Now, does that make sense? Visual space is the alphabet. It's abstract, it's black and white. With the alphabet in the Gutenberg galaxy of print, light was reflected off the page to the user. All right?
Okay.
Once we had the electric environment, we had light through
the type.
All right? Like a stained glass window.
So McLuhan, this question is inevitable, I guess. You're probably sick of it. Why is the medium the message? Why is not the message the message?
Where would you look for the message in an electric light?
Is there necessarily a message in an electric?
There certainly is. Or a candle. The medium and the message are the same. Where would you look for the message when you
in
think
an electric
of
light?
The medium as a container. You are thinking in visual terms, the hidden meaning of a container is the visual.
Take the pun on the word media. He really made the word media famous, but it was around in advertising since the 20s, and he did a pun on media, because when people read understand media, they thought he was talking about the news, the wall of Cronkite advertising. No, he considered every artifact humans made as a medium. Considered every artifact humans made as a medium.
Considered every artifact humans made as a medium.
So he was talking about everything. On that level, he was a philosopher. He just brought up a new word. It's like understanding reality. But he used a proper word. And like a true poet, they always pick up a word that's in use in business and corporate reality that people don't know about, and then he puts it out there, and they think it's that name, but he's putting on the whole history of knowledge.
By studying the pattern of the effects of this huge vortex of energy that in which we're involved, it may be possible to program a strategy of evasion and survival.